After I graduated from college, I was really praying and asking the Lord, what do you want me to do with my life? And he told me to go and to make disciples and to bring the message of the gospel to the college campus and to the people that I could really relate with.
He set me free and he sends me out there and he wants to use me to help set others free.
I love getting to meet girls on the campus who just are desperate to know God and are desperate to find him and have a relationship with him.
Welcome to Northern Colorado, home of Colorado State University and the University of Northern Colorado. Our mission is to evangelize college students during a very crucial time in their lives with the gospel of Jesus Christ. Did you know that 19 out of 20 people who become Christians do so before the age of 25? After 25, the likelihood of salvation drops dramatically. At CSU and UNC, there are over 37,000 students representing all 50 states and over 100 nations. All of these young people are at a critical time of life and desperately need to hear the gospel. No other secular institution influences our society more than the college campus. The decisions that these future leaders make today will influence the direction of our nation and world tomorrow. Each day, students are confronted with tremendous moral and academic pressures. Peers and professors bombard them with secular humanistic philosophies, anti-Christian ideologies, and man-made theories. Together, we can impact this generation with the gospel of Jesus Christ. Each year, the staff of Grace Christian Church shares the gospel with approximately 12,000 students. Through one-on-one interaction, non-confrontational surveys, and personal testimonies, we meet and identify people who are receptive to the gospel. Did you know that 95% of people who become Christians do so through a friend or family member? Developing meaningful relationships greatly enhances our evangelistic outreach to young people. Through more than 100 weekly Bible studies, the staff of Grace Christian Church sows the Word of God into the lives of non-Christian college students on campus, in residence halls, fraternities, and sororities. Each Sunday, we meet for powerful worship, the teaching of God's Word, and dynamic Christian fellowship. Out, Lord, and we will go to spread the news that redemption's here. Send us out, cause they need to know. Young people are demonstrating the power of God by sharing their personal testimonies of Jesus Christ with other students on campus.
When I came to college, I was really focused on my studies, and I was really pretty into the party scene. I actually got really involved with drugs and alcohol, and just the peer pressure that was involved with that really influenced me a lot. And so I just kind of started going in directions that I never really thought I would go. I kept crossing lines that when I was younger, I never thought I would really cross.
So I grew up going to church and I believed in God, but my dad passed away when I was 9 and I didn't really know how to handle that or really what to think about it. And I began to turn away from the Lord and began to give my heart to other things and just started living my own way.
When I came to college, I considered myself like a good kid. I kind of grew up a lot in the church scene when I was younger. I went to church every Sunday with my family, and even though I did all those things, I still felt like an emptiness and like a void in my life.
All throughout high school, I had these lines in the sand that I had drawn of moral standards that I promised myself I would not cross. And as I came to CSU, one by one, I began to cross those lines. And my sin was catching up to me. And I was finding that there was no satisfaction or fulfillment in these things, in this college lifestyle that I was experiencing.
The second week on campus at CSU, I met an evangelist with Grace Christian Church. He said, "Can I ask you a few questions about what you believe in?" And I was like, "Yeah, actually, that'd be great."
And he asked me a question that I had never heard before. You know, when Jesus Christ died on the cross for you, Blake, how much of his life did he give for you? I was like, "All of it." And he said, "How much of your heart, how much of your life does he deserve and ask for?" And I said, "All of it." And at that moment, the Holy Spirit just arrested me, and I was taken aback because I knew for a fact that I had not made this decision to come into that relationship with Jesus that he was talking about.
But thankfully, an evangelist stopped my brother. He had been going to Bible studies and had gotten saved and invited me to church because he knew I needed it and he knew I was just in a really tough spot. And
the evangelist I was doing Bible studies with was really starting to, she started to really teach me really what Jesus' crucifixion was like, and she started explaining it to me, which I had never heard before, and it just like really touched my heart.
When I came to church and the Lord revealed himself to me and really met me with love, when I thought he was gonna reject me because I knew the way I was living was wrong, but he just extended his hand out to me, and that really drove me to repentance, that drove me to the cross, because I saw the love that he has for me, and I didn't want to spend any more of my life apart from him and outside of that.
And I just made a decision to do that, to repent, to turn from living my life as if it were my own, and to say, Jesus, I'm going to follow you with everything.
And in that moment, I felt a weight lifted off my shoulders. I felt clean on the inside. I felt the guilt, the shame, the condemnation lift.
He met me there. He changed me from the inside out. And I really felt this love for him that I had never had before. And I was so excited about that. I mean, it changed me completely.
I just like really felt forgiven and just really excited, and like just this new zeal for the gospel, and was just really excited to be able to tell everybody about like just like what happened to me, like what the Lord did.
My little brother and sister, shortly after that, I shared the gospel with them and they repented, and our whole family has just been completely restored and redeemed, and I'm just so grateful and thankful for what he's done and what he's going to continue to do.
Jesus said to go preach the gospel and make disciples of all nations, and all the nations come to the college campus. And he set me free, and he sends me out there, and he wants to use me to help set others free.
My name is Whitney Collins, and I'm an evangelist with Grace Christian Church. Thank you so much for taking the time to consider partnering with us to reach college students with the gospel of Jesus Christ. Partnership happens through your prayers, finances, and personal referrals. Without this, we would not be able to reach the young men and women that you heard from today. Thank you again for taking the time to consider your role in this crucial ministry.